Okay. Hello, bonjour, bom dia. Estamos iniciando o segundo dia do Canada Lei CCBC Online Festival. Temos uma série de atividades acontecendo durante esse dia e, na verdade, durante essa semana. Começamos ontem o evento com várias apresentações e com muitos conteúdos e discussões interessantes. Temos hoje uma programação intensa que vai seguir até domingo. Então, convido a todos para que não só se envolvam nos programas de hoje, mas que também entrem no site do festival, pesquisem outras atrações e, principalmente, uma lista de aproximadamente 200 conteúdos selecionados falando sobre cultura, esportes, artes, cinema, vídeos, música, gastronomia, visitas virtuais e roteiros inesquecíveis. Realmente, todos são materiais gratuitos que podem ser baixados e compartilhados entre todos. Gostaria, então, de agradecer aqui o apoio do governo canadense e especialmente da Air Canada, que é o patrocinador oficial desse evento. E para iniciar o dia de hoje, gostaria de chamar aqui a Thais Aoun, Laurence Fouquet-Tremblay e Elisa Fiuza, as duas vindas se conectando diretamente de Montreal para falar sobre Montreal como um líder em tecnologia e inovação. Então, temos aqui agora a palavra para a Thais. Bom dia, bonjour à tous e bonne fête du Canada.
Bom dia, bonjour, Paulo. Bom dia a todos. Em nome do governo do Quebec, eu gostaria de agradecê-los pela presença e desejar-lhes boas-vindas a este webinar sobre Montreal, uma cidade líder em tecnologia e inovação. Para aqueles que não me conhecem, eu sou a Thais Aoun, diretora interina do Escritório do Quebec em São Paulo, que tem como missão desenvolver as relações entre o Quebec e o Brasil em diferentes setores, sobretudo economia, política, cultura e educação. Aproveito a ocasião para parabenizar a Câmara de Comércio Brasil-Canadá, representada aqui pelo Paulo e a sua equipe, pela organização de um programa de atividades em torno do Dia do Canadá. E também gostaria de parabenizar a Agência de Desenvolvimento Econômico da Grande Montreal, chamada de Montreal Internacional, por sua importante contribuição para essa programação. Fico muito honrada por ter sido convidada a abrir esse evento, que tem como objetivo apresentar Montreal como uma grande potência nos campos da inovação e tecnologia. Antes disso, para contextualizar, eu gostaria de fazer uma breve introdução sobre a província do Quebec, onde a cidade de Montreal está localizada. Então, Quebec é uma província francófona no Canadá, cuja língua oficial é o francês, sendo ela a maior dentre as 10 províncias do país. Possui grande abundância de recursos naturais, sendo a água o mais importante deles. Tem uma pequena população de mais de 8 milhões de habitantes, que tem como característica serem extremamente acolhedores, calorosos, criativos e inovadores. É uma sociedade que tem muito orgulho das suas origens, de sua língua e de sua cultura. No âmbito econômico, Quebec é conhecida por sua economia diversificada, sua localização estratégica, seus numerosos acordos de livre comércio, suas exportações em expansão e sua capacidade de inovação, especialmente em indústrias de ponta e de alta tecnologia. É também a província canadense que mais investe seu PIB em termos percentuais em pesquisa e desenvolvimento no país. O Quebec tem papel de destaque no seu setor de tecnologia, informação e comunicação norte-americano. Além disso, e devido à sua proximidade com os Estados Unidos, o Quebec tem acesso a um mercado consumidor enorme de cerca de 500 milhões de pessoas. Agora, falando mais especificamente sobre Montreal, que é uma cidade para mim de coração. Esse grande centro de expertise de inteligência artificial, reconhecido mundialmente, acolhe pesquisadores, incubadoras, startups e gigantes do setor, como Facebook, Microsoft, Google e Samsung. Não é por acaso que Montreal receberá quase 500 milhões de dólares canadenses por 5 anos para a criação do cluster de inteligência artificial do Quebec. A cidade também é um grande centro universitário de pesquisas do Canadá e é a sede do maior e mais influente grupo de pesquisadores de deep learning do mundo. Fato é que são muitas as empresas estabelecidas em Montreal que possuem grande capacidade de inovação e que detêm reputação mundial nos mais variados setores. Muitas outras coisas poderiam ser ditas sobre Montreal, e após a apresentação de Montreal Internacional, que vai abordar essas questões em mais detalhes, sinceramente espero que vocês descubram o imenso potencial que essa cidade vibrante oferece para quem quiser fazer negócios, estabelecer empresa, estudar, viver, se divertir. Agora, deixo vocês na agradável companhia das queridas Laurence e Elisa, de Montreal Internacional. Ladies, o microfone é de vocês.
Muito obrigada, Thaís. Bom dia a todos. Bonjour a tous. Hi, everyone. É um prazer estar aqui convosco esta manhã. O meu nome é Laurence Fouquet, sou o diretor do projeto de investimento na Montreal Internacional. And now you're going to, excuse me for that, and I'm going to switch to English because as you can see, my Portuguese is not on point. I can understand it, but it's hard for me to speak it now, but I promise I'm working on that. I know, Paulo, I've been saying this for a long time now, but I promise really hard that I'm trying. And so basically, I'll just let my colleague introduce herself as well.
Bom dia a todos, meu nome é Elisa, eu trabalho na Laurence, desculpa, eu trabalho no Montreal Internacional com a Laurence, é um prazer estar aqui com vocês hoje.
So we're going to do this presentation bilingual. Basically, we're going to start with a little part in English, where I'm going to introduce you to all the different sectors that are of added values in Montreal, the main sectors of Montreal, and then we're going to follow up with Elisa that is going to explain you more into details, the tax incentives, for example, and more the details on how to set up shop in Montreal and more what are the advantages for your company to set up shop in Montreal. First of all, we're going to start with a small video. It's just actually to introduce Montreal International, but also to introduce you to the city of Montreal for those of you who haven't visited yet. It's going to be like a small travel from your home. I know now the situation is not really nice, so we can unfortunately not travel. So we hope that this small video will actually help you change your minds from your apartment or your home right now. And hopefully it will give you the taste of Montreal. So we're just going to start with that.
Our city is unique. It buzzes with creativity. It beats to the rhythm of its own success. And we're here to make sure our metropolis, with its rich history and promising future, shines on the global stage. We are Montreal International, the investment promotion agency for Greater Montreal. We hold the keys to this region with infinite potential, opening every door to investors, entrepreneurs, organizations, professionals, and students around the world. With the strength of our network, we're here to support you in building connections, forging collaborations, and bringing your projects to life. We're here to show you all the city has to offer. From aerospace, VFX, and artificial intelligence, to video games, life sciences, and health technologies, we know our metropolis by heart, its hidden gems, its needs, and its endless possibilities. Our mission is to share with you the assets that define the region's identity, its cosmopolitan energy, its safe and open culture, its strong purchasing power, and above all, its quality of life that's known around the world. So welcome home to Montreal.
So this is to give you a little overview of Montreal and obviously of Montreal International. We are the Economical Development Agency for the Greater Montreal Area. So basically, we have a lot of different mandates. One of our mandates is to help foreign companies set up shop in Montreal. As we are an independent organization, I mean, independent from governments, but we're partly subsidized by governments, that means that all our services are free and confidential. So after the presentation, if you have any question, don't hesitate to reach out to us. Our mail or email address is going to be shown at the end of the presentation. So let's start with Montreal. As you can see on the map, well, this is where Montreal is. So it's about 6 hours drive from Toronto, 6 hours drive, five hours drive from Boston and New York. It's really, we call it the gateway in between North America and Europe, mostly because of this location. As Thais mentioned earlier, well, she was talking about Quebec, but she was saying that Quebec is a small population of 8 million of residents. So Montreal actually is home to 4.3 million of these residents. So it's the capital the metropolis of Quebec, because the capital is Quebec City, the institutional capital. Basically, Montreal is formed with 23% of population that 23% of the population that is foreign born. So as you can see, it's a very multicultural and diverse city. A lot of languages are spoken. Portuguese is obviously one of them. English, French, obviously. Thais was mentioning that Quebec is a French province, and this is obviously true, but Montreal is a bilingual metropolis. So we can speak French or English in Montreal everywhere. You can work in French or English. Obviously, it's better if you speak both, but you can definitely do business in Montreal only speaking in English. Just wanted to precise this before we start the presentation. So the economy, we're actually the second largest economy in Canada. Oh, it's okay. It's just, you can switch it. No problem. So we're the second largest economy in Canada after Toronto. And these are the high value added sectors that we have in Montreal. We're going to do today, it's a short presentation, so we could talk hours about Montreal, but we're going to try to synthesize and talk to you about the most important stuff, which are five basically most important sectors in Montreal. Most of them are in technology and innovation. So that's why the title of our presentation is about technology and innovation. The first sector that is really, really important in Montreal is that Montreal has become a very important AI hub in the last, I'd say, 5 years. We have the first highest concentration of deep learning researchers in the world. We're going to talk a little bit more into details about the AI hub in a couple of slides, but I just want to do this as a quick introduction. The second sector very important in Montreal is video games. We're the top five largest video game development hub in the world. We have a lot of companies and a very strong ecosystem in video game. We are also very strong in life sciences and health technologies. The top six in North America. And it's a bit related to video games, but because of the video game ecosystem, we also created a very strong hub in VFX and animation over the past. The video game has been starting to create itself around the 97 because of the tax incentive that we're gonna talk a bit much later. And so the VFX and the animation hub followed more, I'd say 10 years ago, creating a large hub of VFX and animation, mostly because the talent pool was there and because the tax incentive also was there. Finally, the other very important sector for Montreal is aerospace, as it is the case also for Brazil. We can switch to the others. I'm sorry, I don't have the control in the presentation. So these are mainly the top reason to invest in Montreal's tech sectors. And we are going to go into them into more details during the presentation. But mostly I would say that we have five top reasons to invest in Montreal. The first one would be the strength of the ecosystems. In every ecosystem, in every industry that we've been speaking of in the earlier slide, it's the case. We have a strong ecosystem because the way it is structured, every system is structured with a cluster. So it really strengthened a lot of the ecosystems. The second one is the talent pool. The third one would be the funding, because as you will see, for all the different industries, we have a lot of fundings from governments, from the government of Quebec, the government of Canada, but also a lot of programs that are in place to help companies for R&D, for example, or tax incentives. finally, the operating costs. We are the second largest economy after Toronto, but we are the cheapest. And we are actually the cheapest city in the cheapest big cities in North America, in not North America, but in the US and Canada, where to do business because of the cost of living that is low and the wages that are lower and the cost of the rent, obviously, that is lower. Finally, the fifth key point to actually top reason to invest in Montreal would be the quality of life. And this, we're gonna talk to you about this at the end of this presentation. So we can switch. These are the top reasons to invest in AI that are pretty much similar, but mostly just to give you an overview of the AI ecosystem in Montreal, it's been created, as I said, 3 or 4 years ago now, mostly because of the talent pool that we have here, but mostly because of the researchers, the quality of the researchers that we have. Maybe some of you have heard of Yoshua Bengio. Yoshua is the winner of the prestigious Turing Award. And he is, the most cited computer scientist per day, but also he is the co-founder of MILA, which is the Montreal Institute for Learning Algorithms or the Quebec Institute for AI. He's a very important actor in the AI scene in Montreal. He's an advisor for a lot of companies. So that actually attracted first a lot of students that wanted to, because he's still a professor at Université de Montréal. So that attracted a lot of students that wanted to actually study with him, to pursue a PhD with him. And that helped also create the talent pool in AI that we have. And also it attracted a lot of companies, mostly from Silicon Valley and from Europe. Because of the talent pool that was here, that is, we all know it, talent is the new gold. So they all wanted to come to Canada, to come to Montreal, to be close to this professor and close to the talent. Joëlle Pinault is another one, very important one. She's more specialized into natural language processing. She's also the head of the Facebook AI Research Lab. But the way it works in Montreal, most of the professors, they are head of labs of big companies such as Google, Facebook, the one that Thais mentioned, IBM, Samsung, all the professors are part-time head of the lab and part-time they have their academia charge. So basically that helps also create the talent pools because they stay in academia and they train the next generation. So we can switch to the other one. About the ecosystem in AI, mostly it's unique because it's super interconnected and super collaborative. This is also a particularity of Quebec in general. The government of Quebec is really, really pushing hard and strong and really putting a lot of money into collaborative research. So they're strongly trying to encourage companies, small companies, medium companies, big companies to actually be able to take advantage of the fact that we have these researchers in Montreal and they're putting in place programs for companies like this to be able to access those programs and to be able to develop research partnerships with the academia. So that this is also why a lot of startups in AI are actually emerging in Montreal, mostly because they see the possibility to grow in AI in Montreal. You can just see a little bit. I was talking about the funding earlier. Oh, sorry, you switched the page, but no worries. I was talking about the funding earlier. This is just to give you an overview of the funding. And Thais mentioned it as well, over 500 million that have been put into developing this hub in Montreal. Okay, we can switch. The FinTech and Financial Services Hub is another hub that is actually starting to create itself right now. It's been, let's say, 2 years, mostly because of the tax incentive of the software development that we already have, and mostly because of the talent pool in AI. So all is interconnected, and it's also a particularity that a lot of the ecosystems, they work together. For example, the FinTech Hub works a lot with the AI Hub, the AI Hub works a lot with the Video Games Hub. So there's a lot of interconnections in all the different industries in Montreal. So as you can see, and I don't want to talk too much about every sector, every hub, but as you can see in the FinTech ecosystem, we have over 5,000 companies in the financial services and in FinTech services. And we are first in North America for green finance, according to the Global Green Finance Index. This is also something that you're probably going to hear a lot about Montreal. There's a huge preoccupation about green and about ethics. So mostly in AI, but in every industry, it's a very strong preoccupation. We can switch to the other apps, and we're going to send you the presentation. So whatever sector you need more information on, don't hesitate. And we're going to go more into details at the end when you have questions, or later this week, or whenever it fits you. For video game, as I was saying, we're the top five largest hub in the world. We're the largest hub in Canada. We have over 140 studios that are established in Montreal. And it's important to say that we have all types of studios. So we have the big ones like Ubisoft, like EA, like Eidos, like Compulsion Games, but we also have this like very small and independent studios as well. And there is a place for everyone. We also have QA players and publishers in Montreal. So you can see a little bit of the successes that we've been developing in Montreal, but Assassin's Creed is probably the most famous one. And we're going to talk later about the tax incentive on video games, but this is basically why we have this hub in Montreal, the talent pool and the tax incentive mostly. Animation and visual effects, I already chatted a little bit about that. It's pretty much the same as the video game hub. It developed itself from the video game hub, basically. We are now one of the largest hubs in the world, mostly because because of the tax incentive that we have, a lot of companies, studios from LA or from Vancouver, they actually opened an office in Montreal because it was more advantageous for them to actually do their VFX and animation production in Montreal. The latest success maybe that you've heard of that has been created entirely in Montreal is Scooby-Doo, the new movie, blockbuster movie by that has been created by RealFX here in Montreal. And maybe just to chat a little bit about this success, RealFX actually opened in Montreal 2 years ago, and they grow from nothing to 400 animator and 400 employee in total. And now they actually released 2 years later an entire movie made in Montreal. So this is a really, really good proof of success in the animation hub industry in Montreal. After that, finally, the life science and health technologies. Basically, what happened with this hub is that in the end of the 90s, beginning of the of year 2000, we had a very, very strong pharmaceutical hub, mostly because of the R&D tax incentives. A lot of the big companies were actually developing and producing in Montreal. It changed a little bit because of the NAFTA, so the production delocate. But since we grew this new AI hub and this new technology hub, then the hub that we can see right now that is forming itself in all the life sciences and health technology is mostly because of the AI and of the IT in general strength of Montreal. We still have these important pharmaceutical companies that are here in Montreal. They are doing a lot of R&D as well, mostly because this tax incentive hasn't changed and it's still very interesting for them to do R&D. Just maybe a quick fact like this, Quebec is actually the province where you can get the most tax incentives for R&D in all over Canada. So you can combine the provincial tax incentive with the federal tax incentive, and it's where you actually have a better tax incentive. So this is for the healthcare, and the aerospace industry is pretty much actually the same reason as the healthcare and life sciences industries. Well, mostly because of the big companies that we already have here, like Bombardier. It attracted also a lot of other companies because of the talent pool that we have in terms of engineers. Just on the island in Montreal, we have 11 post-secondary education establishment, and among them we have four or five, if I'm not mistaken, engineering faculties. So basically a lot of new engineers are going out of these different schools every year, so that's why also it helped created the hub, mostly also because of the R&D tax incentive, as I mentioned. As you can see, 70% of the R&D in Canada in aerospace is done in Montreal. So this is just an overview. Oh, sorry, I forgot. We had added this one as well. So the Innovative Manufacturing Hub is also a new, I wouldn't say new, but I'd say new in the terms that it's been developing for, let's say, 5 years mostly. also mostly related to AI and technology in general, innovation. And maybe something very important or interesting for you to mention is that when the government of Canada decided to set up a 5 superclusters, they actually decided to set up the supercluster in AI in Montreal, mostly because of the strength that we already have. But the interesting fact about this is that this new supercluster that is called Scale AI is focusing mostly on AI applied to supply chains. And its purpose is actually to help companies, small, mediums, and big companies, to introduce AI in their supply chain. So this is also why the Innovative Manufacturing Hub is more and more present in Montreal. Finally, the electric and smart transportation. This is also a new thing of the Quebec government, if I can say it like that. The actual government is really focusing a lot on the lithium battery industry and on applying AI and green energy to transportation, mostly because, as you know it, probably Quebec is a leader in green energy. All of our energy is actually produced by hydroelectricity. So this is why also you see Hydro-Quebec, the logo of Hydro-Quebec in this slide. We have a lot of hydroelectricity. And this also is very interesting for companies that are developing smart and electric transportation. Finally, just a quick overview of the recent investments by global players that have been done in Montreal since February 2015. These are only the investments related to technologies-ish. But as you can see, and as Thais mentioned, a lot of big players are investing in Montreal, such as Google, IBM, Morgan Stanley. Actually, an interesting fact, Morgan Stanley has its biggest software development office in Montreal, actually more than 2,000 employees. It's their cost center that they have here, mostly because of the tax incentive on software development. So as you see as well, DeepMind, which is owned by Google, another AI lab, Behavox announced first in July 2018, and they recently announced, I think a week ago, that they're going to move their headquarters from New York to Montreal, and they're planning on creating 400 jobs in Montreal. You can also see a lot of other AI labs, such as Facebook Research. Quantum Black is an AI lab as well from McKinsey. And I cannot see the other one at the end because my face is actually hiding it, but I'll let you see. And I'll let the floor to Elisa, who's going to continue the rest of the presentation.
Thank you, Laurence. So, como a Laurence falou no começo, a nossa ideia era de fazer uma apresentação bilíngue, então eu vou continuar em português. Então, além de ter um ecossistema muito rico e diverso nas indústrias que ela acabou de mencionar, Montreal também possui um ecossistema de startups muito forte. Como vocês podem ver, o Canadá foi eleito pela OCDE como o país mais atrativo do mundo para empreendedores. 6 dos 8 fundos de capital de risco mais ativos do Canadá têm sede aqui em Montreal, e investimentos de mais de 1,7 bilhões de dólares americanos foram feitos na cidade desde 2018. Isso ajuda, então, a explicar a presença de tantas incubadoras, aceleradoras e espaços de coworking aqui em Montreal. Montreal apresenta os custos operacionais mais baixos, né, entre as maiores áreas metropolitanas dos Estados Unidos e do Canadá. Em média, esses custos são cerca de 26% mais baratos para os setores tecnológicos, variando entre 23% no caso do processamento de alimentos, até 32% no caso do setor de inteligência artificial. Eu vou entrar em detalhes mais adiante, mas isso se deve a 3 motivos principais: os incentivos fiscais, o baixo custo de vida e, consequentemente, os salários que também se tornam mais baixos. Então, como eu acabei de mencionar, essa vantagem é em parte causada pelo fato da cidade ter salários mais acessíveis para profissionais do setor tecnológico, apresentando os salários mais baixos do Canadá e dos Estados Unidos, como vocês podem ver nesse gráfico. Nesses slides, vocês podem ver um resumo dos incentivos fiscais disponíveis na província do Quebec. A minha ideia não era de entrar muito em detalhes, porque, como vocês podem ver, há incentivos fiscais específicos para cada tipo de indústria, mas eu gostaria de destacar dois aspectos. O primeiro é que há duas categorias de incentivos fiscais aqui no Canadá. O federal, que é cujo montante é o mesmo em qualquer província do Canadá, e o provincial, que varia de acordo com a província, obviamente. Em geral, os incentivos provinciais podem ser combinados com os federais, e o que eu gostaria de destacar é que o Quebec tem os incentivos fiscais mais altos para pesquisa e desenvolvimento, como a Laurence já mencionou. O segundo aspecto é que os incentivos fiscais disponíveis no Quebec são, em geral, reembolsáveis. Vou tomar como exemplo o incentivo fiscal para o desenvolvimento de software. É um incentivo fiscal de 30%. O que significa? Significa que desses 30%, 24% são concedidos pelo governo do Quebec e são reembolsáveis. Em termos práticos, significa que ao final do ano fiscal, mesmo que a empresa não tenha que pagar impostos, ela vai receber de volta do governo do Quebec um cheque com 24% do valor que a empresa pagou em salários para os desenvolvedores do software. E os demais 6% é a parte cedida pelo governo federal e é não reembolsável, o que significa que, a partir do momento em que a empresa tem que pagar impostos, ela pode descontar esse incentivo fiscal do total que ela vai ter que pagar no final. Caso vocês tenham alguma dúvida específica sobre um setor em particular, no final da apresentação a gente vai ter um tempo para as perguntas. Como eu já comentei, o Montreal tem o menor custo de vida quando comparado a 209 cidades da América do Norte e da Europa Ocidental, como mostra esse gráfico. Os aluguéis são muito mais baratos, os custos com seguro de saúde também. Um outro fator importante é que o acesso a creches para as crianças também é muito mais acessível. Então, sem nenhuma dúvida, a qualidade de vida aqui em Montreal é excepcional. Diferentemente de outras províncias do Canadá, e sobretudo quando comparado com os Estados Unidos, as matrículas universitárias são muito mais baixas, já que a educação é subsidiada aqui no Quebec. Então, isso faz com que muitos estudantes internacionais venham estudar aqui e depois decidam ficar, como é o meu caso, sou a prova viva disso. Montreal é a segunda melhor cidade do mundo para millennials, é uma cidade super segura, com baixíssimas taxas de homicídio. Além disso, nós temos um sistema de saúde universal, que é, inclusive, acessível para trabalhadores estrangeiros. Enfim, a vida cultural é realmente muito rica, sempre tem muitos festivais, muitos eventos, museus. Agora, com o Covid, a situação está um pouco diferente, mas normalmente a cidade é muito, vida cultural muito vibrante, independentemente, sobretudo no verão, mas também durante o inverno, mesmo que esteja com neve, com frio, as pessoas não ficam paradas, sempre tem o que fazer. Então, para acabar a nossa apresentação, aqui é um resumo dos principais serviços da Montreal Internacional. De uma forma geral, nós apoiamos as empresas estrangeiras que desejem se instalar aqui em Montreal. Por exemplo, nós temos uma equipe de economistas que pode fornecer dados importantes para as empresas, como, por exemplo, fazer uma comparação dos custos operacionais entre as diferentes cidades que a empresa esteja considerando para sua internacionalização. Nós não somos governo, mas nós sempre trabalhamos com os governos federal, provincial e municipal. 85% do nosso financiamento vem da parte dos governos, então nossos serviços são gratuitos e confidenciais. Então, a gente está aqui realmente para apoiar as empresas e não existe nenhum custo ligado aos nossos serviços. E aqui, por fim, está o nosso contato, o meio da Laurence. Então, caso vocês tenham alguma dúvida ou queiram mais detalhes sobre algum dos setores que a gente comentou, fiquem à vontade para nos escrever. Imagino que depois a CCBC também vai compartilhar a apresentação. Agora eu vou sair.